Hi. Wasn't this year an extra? Not this year. Wasn't 2020 a leap year? Cynical, you said your birthday was yesterday. Wasn't the 31st of January was like, that's not a common thing, right? How did you have a birthday yesterday when the 31st is like, not, like, actually typically a day? No, wait, we do have a 31st. I was lied to. I heard this last year was a leap year, which had one more day of the month or whatever. Oh, it was February, that's right. Well, happy birthday last year. Did we get quality options? Nope. RIP. What movie did I watch? I watched Avengers. Infinity War? Part 1, whatever that one's called. Infinity War and then Endgame, right? So Infinity War. I finished it today because I can't sit down through one full movie. I gotta do that multiple sittings. Thoughts on that? I mean, I've seen it many times. I think they're great movies. Nothing beats the freaking moment, man. And there's moments in those movies in theaters. They're just like, well, you'll remember forever. Just because of the crowd reaction. Like when Thor arrives. Freaking crowds, like, great stuff. Well, I mean, that's, no. I mean, the movie I just watched. But also, Endgame. When everyone arrives, but specifically, when Captain America wields the flippin' hammer. Good stuff. And it's like, man, that had been building up for like how many years, man? Since the first Iron Man movie, that had been building up to that moment. When was that? 2008, man. It was seriously like 10 flipping years. Build up for that. Freaking insane that it's just all finally crescendoed. Holy fuh! Thanks for the 1,000 bits. That's like $10,000 or something, right? Thanks a lot for the $10, though. Thank you. They always mix this wrong. It's like all the good stuff on top and then down, like, middle, just pure vanilla. There's no cinnamoniness, there's no freaking cookie dough, there's nothing. It's just vanilla. They, like, put all the good stuff on top and then it's just like, okay, now I'm just eating vanilla ice cream at this point. Like, what am I paying for? Back for Blood. I don't know. It could be good, but I don't think that it will be. I've already said it. I predict that the game's gonna flop and that Turtle Rock will go out of business. Because they're freaking gigantic failure of all. After that, they can't fail again. And if they do, they're freaking dumb. And I really think that this isn't going to do well and they're going to fail. Or, like, just go out of business. What? Someone imports Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Oh, 2019 weapons. I was gonna say Speedy's Left 4 Dead server already had Call of Duty weapons in them, but not 2019's. The reveal was promising. Why play the alpha? Everybody could have, well, not everybody, but most people could play the alpha. I streamed the alpha, and it wasn't. I liked it. I liked it just fine, but there was nothing there that would make me want to keep playing it like Left 4 Dead. I mean, yeah, it was alpha, but what more can you change? You can make balance changes, sure, but like everything's there and present. I don't know. I thought what they were gonna do when they first announced it and the way they were talking, to me it sounded like it's gonna be a big, and this is the way it sounded. He's gonna be like bigger. We're going big. And I'm like, oh. And the way he said it, it made me think, oh, it's going to be like this giant world that, like, randomly generates how you beat it or something, you know, to give it the replayability factor. Like, multiple giant maps, and it's random how you beat it. Like, maybe, random objectives to do, or just it formats differently each time, but it just seems like a typical campaign, and the characters definitely aren't carrying it. The characters aren't that interesting at all, from what I saw. Could change, but a big part of the Left 4 Dead was the characters themselves, right? Which is why most people prefer 1 over 2, because of the characters. I don't know. And again, this company is really scummy with their DLC. So I don't know how they're gonna... I mean, sure, they had to have learned their lesson after Evolve. With their freaking $100 monster download. Like, here's a new monster for $100. It's like, what? I'm sure it will be cards. There'll be skins, which is duh. But there'll probably be like OP cards you could buy. What did they say in the video? I think I saw that. I didn't see the video, but I think I saw they did the video. They didn't post the video on their Twitter? Well, then where was the video posted? The frick? That's weird. Sure, on YouTube. Why didn't their Twitter link it? Why didn't the Twitter be like, hey, here's a new video we did? That's weird. Yeah, link it. That's really weird. They didn't freaking embed it or even link it on their Twitter. Also from the alpha, which, good lord, I hope they change. The game encourages zero team play. There's no reason to really stick with each other because there's no monsters that pin you. There's no monsters that will pin you. Left 4 Dead had that insane balance where every monster did their specific pin. They will pin a player in place until someone saves them. And there's one monster in Back to Blood that pinned you. And I don't know if this is true, but when I got pinned, someone said, oh, it wears off over time. If that's true, that's stupid. And there's only one. There needs to be multiple flipping specials that will pin the character so that you have to stick together team play. That was the whole point of Left 4 Dead. That was the whole point. That was the whole freaking formula of the game. Was sticking together so that you can save each other from getting grabbed by a monster.
Pioneers within the industry, Turtle Rock Studios has been working on a brand new and original game. Returning to their roots, they plan to deliver the definitive next-gen co-op zombie FPS with Back 4 Blood.
We've had to sit by for the past 10 years and watch other people sort of riff on something that we created.
The community has been asking us for a new co-op zombie shooter for a really long time.
As creators of Left 4 Dead, we want to take what made the zombie co-op shooter experience so fun, and then couple that with modern-day graphics, modern-day technology.
We're being given an opportunity to redefine the genre that we created.
So if you're looking to spend time with your buddies, mowing down zombies and making a big bloody mess, this is the game for you.
For this game, you know, it wasn't enough just to survive. We really felt like we want to do something new. We want to do something fresh. We want to push the genre. The survivors have rallied together, and now we're finding ways to push back.
You are amongst a handful of survivors that were either resilient enough to make it through a year of complete chaos, or you're actually immune. The immunity gives the main characters a sense of bravado and confidence that normal folks don't have. You're no longer trying to find a safe place, right? You're trying to create safe places. And part of the way you do that is by going out, guns blazing, and killing as many infected as you can.
From the very beginning, we knew what kind of game we wanted to make, and we identified the things that would get us there. Thrilling moment-to-moment gameplay, four-player co-op with competitive PvP, a bigger fight with much bigger enemies, and extreme replayability. Before we start...
That's another thing. I wonder how much DLC-ridden mess will the multiplayer be. You know? That might be a mess.
Start spending time on making sure that the game looks good. We have to make
also the extreme replayability. How are you doing that?
Make sure exactly. That we have a fun core gameplay experience.
We've been playtesting Back 4 Blood since the third month of being on the title, and we playtest close to every day because we have to ensure that no matter what we do, that moment to moment is what people are expecting from us. We think our co-op's different because co-op isn't about just putting four people into a mission together. Co-op's about identifying tasks and activity and gameplay that depend on people working together. If they're not working together, it's not true co-op.
There is no lone wolfing in this game. You need your friends to survive.
Those times when you're completely hoarded by zombies, right? And feel like you're not gonna make it. And then somehow, you know, you and your team manage to pull it all together and survive and destroy the opposition. It's an awesome feeling. It's an adrenaline rush. It's one of those moments that make you wanna slap your buddies on the back and cheer and have a beer.
We wanted our characters to feel stronger in the world and carry better weapons and be more organized as a unit. And so as a result, we really needed the zombies to step up their game. The Ridden in our world are a lot different than regular zombies. We still have kind of the common zombies, the traditional ones that you might see, or the fast zombies. Even those, we added variety. That's where the mutated zombies evolve.
We have zombies that explode. We have zombies that vomit on you. We have zombies that crawl up walls to get a higher position on you and jump on you.
Our tall boy is a 9-footer. He's got a big, sort of lumbering, slow, overheaded attack.
Wait, he's really...
When you dodge, you feel really, really good.
He's really called Tall Boy.
And when you get hit by it, you go flying back.
With Back 4 Blood, you get...
Because that's what I was like say when I saw him. Uh-oh, Tall Boy.
The unique opportunity to actually play as special mutations
is one of the things the community asks for the most.
As a cleaner, you're going to spend a lot of time getting vomited on, getting pounded into gristle. And the nice thing about Back 4 Blood is that we give you the opportunity to take the role of one of these mutated Ridden and deal some of that punishment to other players.
Turtle Rock believes that a good game isn't defined by a single playthrough, but by its ability to evolve over time. Replayability is key, and one of the most important components in keeping Back 4 Blood's gameplay feeling fresh is its game director.
Which needs balancing.
We monitor players, we monitor their actions, we monitor their health, and then we start choreographing the world around them. And the idea is to
like the game director felt so... It felt like it was on a timer. That's all the game director felt like. It's like all... Shoot, 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 special, special, special. Shoot, 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 special, special. It just didn't feel dynamic at all. It felt like it was just on a timing loop.
Be that everybody gets a roller coaster ride.
So when you start a game, one of the first things that you're going to see is the corruption cards that the game director has played against you.
Whether it makes the world super dark or super foggy and limits your visibility, or if it's throwing hordes of mutant-ridden at you, right, that now you got to face eight of them.
And so then you're able to choose from your cards what it is that you're going to counter with. You try different card combinations with your friends. You can play through the full campaign. You can replay the same mission. No experience is going to be the same twice.
We're going to be constantly making content and watching other people make content that we can share with each other. Gamers are going to be showing us things we didn't even know could happen.
We want the game to change over time, and so we're excited to release the game see what the community attaches to.
If they're going to want to do deals, like paid DLC and crap, I don't know how there'll be any sort of user content mods or anything like that.
To and what they get really excited about.
We want to keep adding to the game, working with the community to make the game better,
because that's what keeps it thriving.
We're really looking at working on this for as many years as we possibly can.
We like creating games that gamers can dedicate themselves to and know that I can always go back and play Back for Blood and have a good time.
You've got your guns, you've got your friends, and you just go and you kick some zombie ass.
We're gonna make it even scarier and even more intimidating. But you're a badass, so it's not gonna be a problem.
You're a zombie killing machine. You slay zombies, and that's your job, and you do it well.
We're not creating a refresh. We're not creating a redo. We are listening to our community to deliver what we do best to advance the genre forward.
It's going to be freaking awesome.
Well, we'll see. Time will tell. Add a new. Well, I finally did it. I got Escape from Tarkov. And I played an offline mode. And I somehow, on my first try, I did it and extracted, and I found out it doesn't save anything. Offline mode doesn't save anything. You have to play online mode. And I was like, oh. I kind of just wanted to play this offline. Against bots. Because let's be honest, online is going to be a freaking nightmare, dudes. I can't imagine how hardcore those people are. They're flipping kill you from a freaking 2 mile away. And I'm over here, like, struggling with the controls. How do I look at my map? I don't want to cheese it. I just wanted to play alone on my own world. I didn't want to play against other people. I just wanted to play against NPCs. You know, like any single player game. Because I saw it had offline mode. I'm like, oh, cool. I'll play offline mode then. Nah, you can't. Can I play online, but against bots online? Like hard bots or something? Because, like, frick. I'll bet you I wouldn't even be able to extract once in that game. The only reason I knew where... I didn't... Offline mode, it's like... My timer was, like, running out. I'm like, where do I go? And I quickly looked at it, like, online real quick. And I'm like, maybe here? And then there was, like, just a bunch of dead NPCs and one live one. And I killed him. And they were all dead in one spot. And I'm like, this has to be the extraction point. And it turned out it was. I know online has bots. But you know what it also has? Not bots. It has butts. Like, big butts. Also, that game runs like trash. Like, what the frick's wrong with that game? I had to run it at, like, medium settings to get good frame rate. Like, I'm like, I'm maxing my settings out. And it's like, yeah, 30 frames per second? I'm like, no. What? On a 1080 Ti? Really? At 1080p? You're going to run this bad? All right. Like, it didn't even look that good at max either. Like, what? What's hurting? What's where's the frames? Where are you, frames? It's too stressful to be enjoyable? No. Don't say that. Why would it be But I enjoyed that little romp in offline mode. I'll just play offline mode and never progress in the game. I'm fine with that, I guess. It was fun. Yeah, but I don't even get any of the crap I get, so there's, like, no point. What the frick? I have Dragon Ball Brawly? Where did I download this? Yeah, this is the whole movie. All right. I want the Blu-ray, though. Do I want to try it? I don't know. I bought the game, so I guess I probably could, should... And then be like, man, I wasted my money. Why is Chrome open? What? Stop. Go away. Please? The fuck are you doing? Wait, it's a... Escape from Tarkov is a Unity engine game? What? Man, that engine's flipping flexible as frick, isn't it? Jeez. You can make anything on that thing. Oh, I guess I need to... Okay. I need to start it with a launcher, because I just opened the EXE, and it's just like... Nah. Where's the launcher? Right there. Wait, what? You have to heal before... This game sounds stupid. I regret buying it. I know you lose your items. If you die, you lose your items. Yeah, I know that, but you have to heal to max health before you can go back? Excuse me? Is that like an incentive for freaking, like, can you like pay to heal? I'll bet you can, right? Is this like a mobile game? Like just like trashy microtransaction hell? Realistic my ass. I'll bet you there's microtransactions. Wait 24 hours to heal or insta-heal with the healing pack. Is this the music? This is weird. See, look, and then it's like, I choose crap? I don't freaking know, bro. Customs? What is that? Insane? What does that mean? Hard? Well, it's either hard or insane. 30 minutes? No, let's do 15 minutes. Yeah, 25 minutes. Wait, the lab, what's that? Insane. 4 to 5, 8 to 13, 10 to 14, 9 to 12. And here's another thing! Are there... Can I come across duos? Or do you have to, like... Is a duo like it's separate server? What is this? You can insure weapons? No, wait, what? What does insuring do? Where's the... What? Currency? Let me guess. You could buy insurance money currency, can't you? This is really just a microtransaction bullshit game, isn't it? What have I done? Oh, customs is the easiest map? No, go back! Uh-oh. Oh, there is no microtransactions? I think I broke the game by clicking back. This game's $30 right now. On a sale. What'd you say? Reserve was the easiest to learn or something. Oh, customs. But it says insane. Wait, it says... Your progress is not being saved due to being offline mode. Huh? But I'm not... Prepare to escape offline raid test mode. What? Why am I in offline mode? I don't have it selected. Explain this. Go back. What? Why was I in offline mode? Oh, do I just push ready? But there's no matchmaking crap, is it? I'll just get shoved in with like a billion people with like the best gear. get popped from a mile away. Why is my character, like, barely jittering around? Is it because it's loading? It better be. Look, it's running, like, one frame per minute. I don't need it on my phone. I have a computer. Tarkov customs map. Okay, is there one extraction in this game, or I mean, in per game, like when the is, it, will I have multiple extractions to go to, or is it just one in every game? Like, does it randomly choose one extraction point, or are there multiple ones I can go to? Because, like, wouldn't that mean every player would go to that extraction point, and then, like, there would, like, only be, like, one person left because of that? Okay, so there is multiple. That makes more sense. Okay, 3 minutes in and no game. Find another game. Oh my god, I love games. This is why multiplayer games are so good, you know? Look how slow the menu is. I hate this. Why did I buy this? Let's play something else. Oh my god, I will give you 10 more seconds, you mother... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, fuck you! No, I'm done. Nope. Nope. It is 2020. I am not waiting that long to get to the main mother effing menu. I just want to look at the menu, bitch. Just the menu. Hey, bitch, the menu. That's all I want to see. Start, menu, options, all that. That's all you got to display for me. No, can't. In like 2 minutes, you can't do that. Okay, bye. We're done. Can I refund the mother effer? Because good lord, I'll refund it based on the freaking menu, the time it takes to get to the menu. I'll refund it on that alone. Who the frick has the patience to sit through that? Tarkov pissed me off and I didn't even get into the game yet. Yeah, it's just like flipping Fortnite. It'll always be in beta or early access just 'cause. It's so crap to do that. Now what? Iron Man mode. Maybe. Yeah, I was thinking about doing that. I mean, it's pretty much what I want, right? Just single player Tarkov. That's funny because I was thinking about getting or installing DayZ. But if DayZ takes longer than that, never mind. And he has DLC? What? Alright, so what faction has a story mode? Wait, does every faction have a story mode? Guess so. Loner, duty, freedom, ecologist, mercenary, and clear sky. Dynamic quest lines can be enjoyed by all playable factions. I'm trying to think if I want to do a story or just randomly thrown in again. Choose a random faction. Go to Brain Scorcher, whatever that is. I don't know why I do Iron Man mode. Yeah, Warfare is broken right now. From all the comments that I have seen. So, never played. I've played Call of Chernobyl and I beat it. Never played Clear Sky or Piprat. And apparently there's a really good mod for Piprat. Called Gunslinger, which I really think Maybe I should just start streaming that. Just start playing through Paprat and stream it. That should just be what I should stream next. I'm playing Call of Chernobyl right now with another mod. It had so many flipping new side quests. It's called Old Good Stalker Evolution Remastered or some crap like that. And it's got so many freaking side, like, new quests that weren't in the original. Yeah, I've heard of, everybody talks about Misery. I don't know if I want to do Misery. Flippin' Gunslinger looks cool because everything has an animation. Like, even turning your light on, right? Like, your character will, like, reach up and press a light on it. Light, turn the light on. Like, everything's animated. And the gunplay's all mixed up. Or all enhanced. Well, I heard Misery's pretty customizable. You can make it less Misery. Miserable. But look, the thing about Misery is it looks flipping. The graphics, like the visual enhancements of it, look really nice. But I don't want to have to deal with all the micromanagement that comes with. This, actually, Anomaly, has like all the Misery crap, right? Like all the flipping little minuscule, like the batteries. And then you gotta disassemble crap for repairs and like cut monsters up with a knife and get a cooking kit to cook and get recipes to cook recipes. It's just like, good lord. I could already add ray tracing. I could already add ray tracing to this if I wanted. Through reshade. Oh, I was gonna do that! I was gonna add reshade to this. Why does it take an hour to load? I wanted to add my reshade preset. Fuck! Ew. I did not mean to ignite the fire. I was trying to talk to the dude. Okay, when I die, remind me to install reshade. I'm not doing story mode, right? I'm just random. So let's just survive right now. Walk away from me! Which one am I? I didn't choose a loadout! I'm restarting. I didn't choose a loadout. It gives you all these points to choose a loadout, and I didn't say I could choose a loadout. For frick's sakes. Alright, I'm gonna reinstall reshade. Reshardo. Ricardo. But here's the question. It has many bins, many EXEs. It would be the DX11 version, right? But here's another question. Anomaly DX11 EXE, Anomaly DX11 AVX.exe. What? Which one does it run? Here's how you find out. You start it and then look at the process, you frick. It's not gonna. Listen, I don't know how the ray tracing reshade is gonna look on this. In fact, It's gonna run like trash, and I probably won't even use it. But I'll use other reshades, such as Ambient Occlusion, which I will show you how much better the game will look with it. Alright, what is this EXE called? It just says X-ray point... X-ray.16 engine. Well, that didn't help. Well, then... It would be in game data. No. Where's that effing engine then you're supposedly running? No. No. No, no, no. Frick. Fine. Well, I know I'm doing the DX11 version, so I'll just install both. To both. May as well. You made a favorite for your Twitch clips. Good luck for that lasting. People like to delete theirs in fear of the old DMCA crap. Devil May Cry. Alright, Abominally. We'll do DX11.exe first. You are DX11. Install, please. I'll just do one and then start it. And then if it doesn't, then I'll do the other one. Success? Success? Record them? Hey, it worked. You don't need to record them, you can just save them. You can save Twitch clips. You don't have to record them off your screen. Okay, where did I put that flippin' reshade? I just have it called McFly Reshade somewhere. And all my icons are messed up because... There it is. Alright. McFly! Retrace, there it is. No, don't cut copy, you frick. All right. And I moved it in the wrong folder. Okay, I hope that works. Alright, now, watch this magic. Watch this magic. What is it? What did I do? I was that, and I was in, what faction did I do? Turn off story mode. I think it was that, right? And I was in, like, what faction did I choose? I want to go to the same one. It looked interesting, whatever it was. Scorcher, right there. All right, Austin, choose your loadout this time. Whoops. Sheesh, that took up a lot of points.
there.
Okay. Am I good? Sure. What did I click? I clicked the back button. Oh, it remembered what I did. Thank you. Holy crap. Now let me show you what a simple addition of ambient occlusion will do to this flipping game. Looks quite nice. Cause you don't notice how flat the game looks. I mean, I did. Without ambient occlusion, the game looks flat. And of course, there's ambient occlusion options, but it does nothing, I swear. Ugh. Alright, now just look at the grass. The grass alone, you'll see the difference. It looks okay, whatever, right? But now watch this. Watch this. Look at that. Look at that difference it makes. Everything gets depth and shadow with it. See that? Let's stack another ambient occlusion on. Darkens everything up a little bit better. Look at this. Look at the difference that simple change made. It goes from like flat and bland to like actually good. See, look at the depth. I mean, because look, it pretty much looks like the grass is just floating there. But when you turn it on, oh look, you can see that it's rooted in and it's got shadows and like darkness underneath it. Now let's try that ray tracing filter and see what it does. What? Why is my button not working? You bitch! It's you. It's you. Why do you F everything up? Real-time global illumination. it just does what the ambient occlusion does, but a little better. So I could turn off the other ambient occlusions and just have the ray tracing on. Let's see how that looks. Yeah. It pretty much does the same thing. It even gives like the trees more depth. I'm gonna make a hard save because my character's just sitting here starving right now. I'm just freaking turning up a hunger meter. So make your changes and then reload. I can also do real-time reflections, which probably would look like trash. No, screen space reflections. It makes everything look wet. Look, the trees are like reflecting now. Everything's like shiny looking. I can tweak that to look really good actually though. It takes a lot of tweaking. It's mostly meant for just screenshots though. Looks really good in the rain though. Especially with light bouncing off like puddles and stuff, but I'm not gonna freaking dink around with that. So that's simple addition of that ray tracing filter. I actually don't know if I like it. I think it darkens things too much. Like even look at the simple change of the railroad tracks. It gives shadows where shadows should be. See, like in the little corner right there on the railroad track, it darkens it where there's no light hitting it. It's really good. But I think it goes too dark. Maybe I can fiddle with it more. Man, somebody's fighting something. Amount of rays? Amount of steps per ray? I don't know what that means. Man, you tweak this quite a bit, huh? Okay, here's where I wanted it. I didn't want it that dark. So. Oh, I can actually tweak it more by seeing the actual maps. See, look how much it's changing. Everything you're seeing right there is what it's affecting. That's pretty freaking intense. That's a really good flip and reshade. Experimental. I don't. Ooh. Sky bounces? Let's turn that on. I don't know what it did. Sky color? What does that do? Okay. Apparently, the sky is very red. Fade out mode. Wait, is there an explanation when I hover over it? No. Material type. I see. It's trying to emulate what the material is. Like, how light would affect that material. Like, on metal, it would, like, brighten it up more. That's freaking crazy, dude. This is actually... I've never really messed with these settings before. Where's my mouse? Where's my freaking mouse? Stop. I can't get my mouse! I can't get my mouse! Wait, there you were. Alright, it's good as is. Play the game, Austin. Okay, reload though. I'm not gonna just keep my dude standing there that whole time. Would have been funny if I just got killed while I was doing that. But look at... I mean, again, look at how good this looks just with that flip and change. Like, it looks like a 2000, early 2000 game with it off. Turn it on, and it's like, wow. It, like, has, like, looks like it has, like, modern lighting systems, which kind of does. The problem is I think this filter's really hitting my frames. FPS is not available. What? You sure about that? Oh, yeah, it's not telling me what my frame rate is. It's pretty rough. I probably shouldn't have it on. I'll just do the regular MXAO. And I lost my mouse again. Why is that a thing? Can I just do this? Gosh. Look, just turn the MXAO on. With the SSDO. And I bet the frames will not be that bad. Oh yeah, it's way better. Man, that friggin' ray tracing filter is intensive. I'm like losing no frames with this on, and it looks... I'd argue it looks just as good, but there's probably way more simulation going on with the ray tracing one. this like a village? Oh, I never figured out how to get the flashlight to work in this game, did I? Oh, I gotta equip my crap, I forgot. Scorcher faction? I mean, that's, it said I was in Scorcher area or something. Let's see how the lighting is affected in this room with it off. Look at the depth it adds. Like, look at the back wall. Look at just how much shadow and, like... This is what freaking, to a rougher degree, this is what ray tracing does, chat. This is why ray tracing is so good, because it does this, but more accurately and more effectively. Because this is just simulation, right? It's not actual ray tracing. And again, you can do this with any game you want on PC. You can do this with any game. You got Steam? Freaking install Reshade. It's free, and it's the easiest freaking thing to uninstall. You just saw me do it. It is so easy to install. And then you can just freaking fiddle around with all these settings. Like, you want the game to look like Borderlands? Okay. Wait, where's that flipping filter? What's it called? Well, there's cartoon, but that doesn't look as good. No. There's comic. That just gives everything hard edges. Where's the paint one? It was called, like... It's called, like, olive... Olive-fi or something. I can't find it. What was it called, then? Pin? Well, there is one that makes it like look like a cartoonish color. Or just... Why am I doing this? Play the game. Olify! Oilify! That's why I always get it wrong. Okay, see? But this is like... This is a little extreme. This is like... Just looks like a painting. That actually looks really good with the MXAO. That looks really good. Like, I wouldn't mind playing a game like this, frankly. Look, I can, like, tweak it a little bit. Give it a little bit more artsy look. Dude, I love freaking reshades. It is so fun to mess with. Okay. You tell me that's nothing? Okay. Oh. Z toggles walk, okay. Okay, flashlight's equipped. I still don't know how to use it. I don't know how to use the flashlight, chat. It has not worked for me in this freaking game yet. Does anyone know? I'm L-ing, I'm O-ing, I'm third-personing. Yo, it's playable in third-person! Look at this. I got a crosshair and everything. What? I've made a mistake. How do I go back to first-person? Oh, Lord! Oh, Lord, help! I blew it. Son of a bitch. Look. Flashlight. Wait, first person view. K? Okay. But look. I saw a flashlight. Flashlight says L. It says L. and I press L, and nothing happens. Nothing happens. Okay. Details. No, don't disassemble the flashlight. The frick? Details. General purpose handheld flashlight. Unfortunately, it cannot be used along most of the weaponry. Oh! Wait, it says it can be used with pistols. It requires a free hand, thus it can be simultaneously used with only a pistol. Okay, that still doesn't work then. What if I unequip and then try to use the flashlight? No. No. It still don't work. I need to know how to use it. Yeah, it said it had batteries. Right? Look. Power, 78%. I'm just gonna have to Google it, because that's too much of an important thing that I need to learn. Anomaly, stalker, flashlight, not working. Auto-filled for me. Flashlight lot working thread. Oh boy. Oh! I think it's going... What slot, then? I think it was going in the wrong slot. What slot, then? No, it just goes to slot. Oh, do I put it on my belt? No? It can only go into that slot. It goes into your detector slot. The headlamp, which go to the top of your right slot, uses the flashlight bind. Hi! It'll only go into that slot, guys. Wait a minute, I think the button's unbound. I think it's O, but O is... I think that's what happened. I think that's what happened. Detector. Yep. It's unbound. It's the detector slot. Okay. Now, am I using Alt? No. So make it Alt. That's it. I figured it out. Why is there a flashlight button? But it is the detector button. I would not have known, figured that out without the flipping internet. That's for dang sure. Did I not just confirm that? Oh my god, what's wrong with you? Okay, it's there. It's still not working. No. I didn't apply the settings, did I? Help me. Detector, Alt, apply. Fuck! Ah! Boy, I'm gonna reload my game, because that took too long. I shouldn't have took that long to figure that out, but I got a flipping flashlight now. Alright, there wasn't really anything in here, was there? I gotta rebind it? Really? The load actually loaded my previous bindings. That's crazy. No, it's there. Oh my gosh. Oh, I didn't equip anything. Oh my god. Listen, I'll play this game eventually. Now save the game, and here we go. Now, you can break these things and get things out of them. Wait, isn't shift grab like... Yeah, there you go. A sleeping bag? No, it can hold a sleeping bag. Yeah, it's an anomaly. It's an anomaly. And I'm just using ambient occlusion for... That's literally all I'm adding for the reshade is ambient occlusion. Which gives depth and shadows to everything. I could add a few more things like... Maybe like HDR. Probably make it too dark though. Oh, yeah. You know what I should add is ambient light. It gives every light source a little glow to it, which really looks nice. Never mind, that looks really bad. Ew, why do you look so bad? Never mind, that looked awful. Could have some curves, because I always like my curves. I did nothing. Play the game. Oh, I had the thing off. Yeah, that looks way too dark. Is anyone getting me a task? Nope. Alright. I mean, whatever faction this area is, yes. And keep in mind, I'm on flipping hardcore, meaning I die, that's it. It erases my saves. So, we'll see how long I can last as this little innocent boy. Boy, I just can't get into that building, can I? Or can I? Ah! Oh! God. Thanks! Why do I have that still? Thanks for the bits. I'm not bleeding or anything, right? I'm gonna reload my game if there's nothing in here. A camera? Oh, it's a headlamp. Broken beyond repair, so it's just for disassembling. To prevent, okay, hold the alt key. What? Proper disassembling tool is required. For frick's sakes! What is that? Bandage. Is there like a lock picking mechanic in this? I got so full of... I'm not gonna get attacked by mutants yet. I'm in the flippin' compound. Right? How do I get out of here now? That's a big question, because the way I got in is not going to be the way I get out. How do I get out of here? Oh, no. Am I stuck here? Come on, you really can't jump out the frickin' window, bro. Oh, maybe I can get out through here. That sounded like some mutant activity to me. Man, these games are so flipping good with the... Reload the game. Remember, I only have one life. I'm not gonna let little things like that wear me down. Monolith, our friend with zombies? Excuse me? Yeah, this is their compound, so I can't imagine there being anything here, enemy-wise. I can climb each one of these. The loot is randomly spawned, too, in Anomaly, so... Items will just be anywhere. Could be anywhere or anywhere. Everywhere. The Whomping Willow. Hurry. You know what? Let's not walk through this tall grass. It's a magical bedspread. Repair bonus. All right. We've got some supplies. No NPCs really gave me any tasks. Guess we go. I probably should have bought some things from guys, but I don't know what they need yet. Food. Ammo.
New Year.
Thanks. Do I go to Laboratory X19? Thanks for the friggin' 666, Falconborn. Thank you so much for the donation. A yes and a no. Wait, isn't this that really bad place? With bad things? Your faction owns this area? Oh. What is this game? What is this in? This ain't Shadow, right? I don't recognize this place, and I've only played Shadow of Chernobyl. So this might be Piperato. Oh yeah, look, they're good guys, they're friends. We all good friends here. Why are you like hiding and being weird? I can't get details on any of the crappy cells. That's weird. Will you complete my task to remove my... Sure. What was my... No active PDA. I'll never make it that far, let's be honest here. What is that? Is that lockpicks? Filled cutlery, steel wool. Filled cutlery. Repair bonus. Everything, I guess, gives you just repair bonuses. Door locked. Door opens. Are you sure about that, game? Surely there can't be anything bad here, right? We got allies in here. Everybody's cleared everything out already. We're good. What do you, bro? Wish I knew what any of this crap was. This dude really wants to get in there. He needs radio protectants. So we can't go anywhere in this place, I guess. Well, look, I have two light sources. Because there was two flashlights looking at me. That was freaking awesome. Or in two shadows. Well, I can't go any deeper. My dick! Okay, I can't go anywhere else. This is not open to the public, apparently. What are you all aiming at? He's got a freaking jackhammer. Yeah, guess we're leaving this place. Cool place, that old laboratory, whatever. Cool place you got there. Ooh, I could go to Piprat. The Dark Forest? I mean, the Red Forest or Piprat? Army Warehouse. Wait, where was I supposed to go? Garage, right? Or garage garbage. Wow, this place connects everywhere. I'd assume for Pratt safer, that's what I was thinking. And I am a safe boy. Wait, I gotta go this way to get out of this oh no, there's a hole right there, it looks like. That's what he said. I can't believe I'm not irradiated after whatever the heck that was. For frick's sakes! Now I'm irradiated. Okay, no, I'm not. No, I kind of am. It'll go away. How do I get to this? Really? The rounds are damaged? You can get bad ammo? Wow. Nothing? Cool. Isn't that what I have already? Why does ice cream always make you so thirsty? And fat! I just chose a random faction. I don't even know what my faction's about, frankly. Man, I love damaged rounds. They're the best to have. Fellow stalker? You know, are you gonna say hi? All right. What rounds does this use? For frick's sakes! Nine-19. Why don't you just say it when I hover over you? Come on. That's annoying. Why is every vehicle radiated? Whoa! Yo, team member. Control with a numpad, if I recall. Stealth mode and stealth mode. Snealth mode. Looting enabled, looting disabled. Passive mode, offensive mode, aggressive mode, passive mode, defensive mode. Wait, follow me. Wait, await, follow me. Whoa, I can tell them where to go? Holy frick! Yo! That's pretty cool, actually. Wait, follow me. Why? Hello? What happened? What happened? Did he push me? What was that? I couldn't control my character. I was like, ugh. Why you say don't worry about rads? In the version I'm playing, rads freaking kill you like crazy. But it ain't anomaly, so maybe it's balanced differently. If you mash the talk button, they get mad at you? Like an old good stalker, if you get flippin' radiated, your health will just drain until you're dead. You have to drink vodka or take or pills, and if you don't have any, you're just dead. And I don't have any. All right, I'm gonna do it. Oh! That's funny. How does vodka help with radiation? Frickin' they're Russian! Vodka helps with everything for Russians. It's the cure-all. You depressed? Vodka. You're running out of money? Vodka. Your wife left you? Vodka. You can't get it up? Vodka. You you drank too much vodka? Vodka. Oh, I thought I was doing a Half-Life fall there. Carbon fiber inserts. Use at workshops for part replacement. I need field armor kits. That'd be cool if I could just shove that Kevlar down my shirt. You know, like, call it poopy. Oh, God! Look, I'm irradiated. I'm gonna die. Well, you're no fun. This is not to Pratt. Where am I even going? Army warehouse. I wanted to go up to see what that was. Yeah, but where's a repair frickin' bench? I don't know any of the areas in these games. I've never played Pratt or Clear Sky. So I don't know where anything is or what anything does. I'm just a Call of Chernobyl newbie. That played through it on the complete mod, which is easy mode apparently. But I am playing again on the old good Stalker remaster, which has been okay. I was playing Autumn, which is like, it looks freaking great, but it's just vanilla. It's just like vanilla Call of Chernobyl. Just prettier. I think the combat's better. It felt really good, actually. The gunplay in Autumn, Aurora. It felt pretty good, but I don't want to just play through that game again. I want new remixes and stuff, so Old Good Stalker adds so many new quests. Aurora's amazing. Best. Why is it best? I mean, it looks dang good. I guess I can see people getting it based upon how good it looks alone. And the gunplay is really good. But it's just the same quests. It's just the same game, right? It's just... Which isn't a bad thing, honestly. If you want to just replay the game, it's not a bad thing. What is that? Medium armor repair kit. I was really debating, though. I kept switching back between Old Good Stalker and Autumn Aurora, and I'm like, which one do I want to play? I can't freaking decide. But I played flipping Old Good Stalker for like 20 hours now, and it's like, eh, I may as well just stay with it. Yeah, Old Good Stalker adds 160 new weapons. Half consumed, okay. Wait, what? What did I... Can I sell that? Yeah, and then there's all the suit mods. Dude, I was... Why didn't any of you guys reply to me on Twitter? I was asking, what's the good mod? What's the best, like, Shadow Chernobyl mod? And no one answered. So I flipping Googled it, and I was like, there's like a billion answers to that question. I'm like, well, I don't freaking know. And I just decided on Old Good Stalker. Floating buttons. Yeah, and then there's all the soup mods, and I was like, well, which is a good soup mod? And like, there's a billion of them. Someone just didn't make, like, a definitive mod. Like, the Autumn Aurora engine, because it's clearly the best engine. It looks the best. All the best mechanics. Best custom side quests. Because there's just so many, man. Many, man. Yeah, when I played back in whenever, 2011, I played the Stalker Complete version, which was good. You're just now unlocking that anomaly? I walked right past it earlier. Sprinting a lot probably isn't a good idea, huh? Probably wears me down. So walk real slow. Doesn't anomaly have fast travel? Like, once you've gone to an area, can't you go back to it fast travel? I thought that was a thing. How do you fast travel? Man, this is a lot slower of a start. The start I did the other day, it was like instantly attacked by bloodsuckers. How did I not see this? Are you sure radiation's not a big deal? 'Cause frick. Boy, this is sure worth it. You know what? And reload. How do you fast travel via debug mode?
Like console command, right?
Do you have faith in Back 4 Blood?
You missed? I just did like a huge discussion on that when I started the stream earlier. Yeah, we talked about that at the start of the stream. Long story short, I don't think it's going to succeed, and I think that it's going to put Turtle Rock Studio out of business. That's what I think is going to happen. I don't want it to, but I think that's what's going to happen. Oh, you just check a debug mode option. Wait, so you can travel anywhere even if you haven't been there yet? Because I remember reading it says you can travel to an area once you've been there. Or fast travel. I swear it was Anomaly. I've been looking at so many mods, maybe it was a different one. You guys see that new, engine demonstration of Stalker 2? It just showed in-engine nonsense, which looked good. Don't get me wrong, looked really good. Dictates a dude being like a follower. It's just random, I guess. Yeah, in-engine really does not represent much. It's like you can do all these cool things in-engine, sure, but in practical use, you probably can't make it look like that, right? Like, that uses the whole budget of the game memory. So, cool, you can do that in-engine, but you gotta spread that out across an entire game. So, it's not gonna look that good, and it's not gonna run that good. Like, they use the entire budget of the game, just like right there, bam! All the RAMs and the parlosecs and the kilosecs and the parlobytes. All right there in the game, in that one scene, and it's like, well, now we can't do anything else. Then again, remember that flippin'. Remember Battlefront did a flippin' in-game engine thing, and everyone's like, yeah, right. For the first Battlefront, they did this crazy scene of them taking down a walker. Everyone's like, yeah, freaking right, it's not gonna look that good. Oh, it did. It looked that freaking good. Battlefront is still one hell of a looking game. And then they ruined it with the latest patch. They made it amazing, and then they ruined it. Battlefront 2. That was the funnest I had had in a multiplayer game in, like, 10 years, man. And then they freaking ruined it. Like, I don't think I'd had that much fun in a multiplayer since, like, Bad Company 2. And then they're like, here's the newest patch where we ruin everything. It's like, oh, thanks. What about Battlefield 3? Oh god! Ah! Just gonna load my game. My first encounter. I didn't even get to fire my damn gun. I didn't even fire my gun. I'm very mad, y'all. Okay. And thus ends the adventures of whoever the hell that dude was. I wonder how his partner got off. Oh, I shouldn't have closed the game. I should have watched and seen if he survived. Because you can watch the game after you die. I should have seen what my partner would have done. Dang it. That was terrifying. Dude, hardcore mode's actually terrifying. I just walked right into him. One shots me! I don't know where endgame areas are. Look, I'm flipping. I don't know anything about those areas. I'm just winging it. Alright. Well, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for hanging. Yeah. You guys have a good night? Hey, tomorrow's Saturday. Sweet. Shop for gear off your allies. Yeah, I probably should have bought some things. Wait, you can kill them? Wait, what? I should just play Outlaw again. Just go kill everybody. Because we all know how that went. Oh, man. Did you guys see that clip or watch last time I played? I played as an outlaw, and I ran into three dudes, and I was like, oh, my hell. I'm so good. I'm dead. And I managed to kill them. I was bleeding out after killing them, and I'm like, I am, like, going to die. I have to get to somebody. And so I ran to some fellow bandits and, like, traded some flippin' just in time before I bled out, got some bandages and med kits, and healed up. And I was like, oh, man. And then I turn around and just walk into an anomaly. I'm like, dude, I survived an encounter! And just walk into a freaking anomaly and just die. It's good stuff. It was a good one. Epic ending. You can be a zombie? What? Wait, hold on a minute. What? I have to see this. What does being a zombie do? Oh, I have to see this. Does it crash your game? Why did it... Hello? What happened? Play Stalker. Please? Okay, well, the game's not starting. Could tell you why, but guess we won't find out. I don't know why it's not. Delete shader cache, sure. Will that fix it? I just wanted to see what being a zombie was like. Hey, that worked. Deleting the shader cache worked. Okay, that's weird. Better than not working. Yeah, the debug option was already selected. Wait, did it work? No. No. Well, I guess this is a problem for another day. Any ideas why it's doing this? I've never had to do this. I've never played it that much, but sound problem workaround? I don't know what the heck's going on. Yeah, that Chimera not only deleted my saves, it deleted my flippin' functioning game. The EXE, gone. Third time the charm. Or fourth time. I love technology. I love it. It's so dependable and accurate. Press Z. I pressed Z. Nothing happened. What is... Is something supposed to happen? Wait, no, look! Brains! Zombified stalkers are mindless husks of their previous... And will attack almost anything that's too close. What?! What is this crap? Well, how does it play? I've got to see this. I'm so curious. Good thing the game loads fast. Real fast. So what is the favorite one? Is it Proprat, Clear Sky, or Call? Like, what is everyone's favorite one? It seems like Proprat seems to be a favorite. For the most part. From what I see. Or maybe everyone just burn out on the original and they're like moving on. I've never played the other ones. I never thought they were worth playing, but apparently they are. So I should totally play Paprat. Alright. Should I just like start streaming it? I'll get the Gunslinger mod and play through Paprat. Hello, fellow zombie. Would you like to go eat some brains? I can shoot my guns? Do I die? Like, can I die? Like... Why do monoliths like zombies? So this is just like God mode then. Are you telling me I can run into a flippin'... I can't. I can't do that. No. Well, I... Gotta learn somehow. Alright, anyway, that's funny. Hey, thanks for tuning in and hanging out. Hey, thanks for the donations from Falconborn. Young Straight, thanks for the bits. Four Phantom, thanks for the bits. You guys have a good evening. Have a good Saturday. Make the most of it.
Not on Pornhub. But X-Hamster, because Pornhub got rid of, like, all their videos, so X-Hamster's, like, the second. It's, like, the place to go now. What the frick? I shouldn't have all that forward. What was that scene that I just witnessed? I was holding a machine gun and there was a dude with me? What was that? Why? I should have just kept playing. What the frick was that? Anyway. Alright, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay? Have a good night. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for hanging. Thanks for chatting. And good night.